How are we doing? This is Marcel with LATICRETE Tech Service. Today I'm going to run down the factors that you're going to need to consider when trying to use strata heat as a primary heat source. We often get the question about using strata heat system to heat a home or a space. The answer is yes, it can be done, but under the right conditions. So I'm going to go over five main factors that you're going to have to consider anytime you're thinking about using strata heat as a primary heat source. Those being climate, the position of the room in the home or the space that you're trying to use it as a primary heat source, the room insulation, type of substrate, and even the type of finished flooring. So let's go over the first consideration, climate. Naturally, the colder the climate that you're installing these systems in, it's gonna make it harder for the strata heat to work to heat that floor, which will thus in hand make it harder to keep that room warm. Another factor you're gonna wanna consider is the position of this room in the house or the building. This factor alone is gonna have a lot to do with if you are able to use strata heat as a primary heat source in a space. For example, does the room have exterior facing walls? Is it only adjacent to other interior rooms? Is it upstairs or downstairs? Naturally, rooms that have no exterior walls are going to be easier to heat, as well as rooms in the upstairs of a house, for example. Insulation is going to play a huge role in deciding if strata heat is going to be the right choice for a primary heat source. This includes more than just insulation behind the walls. It's also going to include how well the windows are sealed, how many windows, are the doors sealed, the number of chimneys, you name it. The more avenues that heat has to get out of these spaces is clearly going to make it a lot harder for the floor to be the sole source of heat in these types of rooms. Therefore, some room with a lot of glass will allow for a lot more heat loss compared to a room with more walls, which in hand is going to make it hard for the strata heat system alone to keep that space at a comfortable temperature, short of just relying on it to keep the floor warm. The type of substrate is going to play a big role too if these systems can be used as a primary heat. Things like if the room is located above a crawl space, or on a concrete slab on grade. You imagine if a concrete slab on grade is in, I don't know, Canada, for example, it's going to be a lot harder for strata heat to be relied on as just being that primary source of heat in that room. In these spaces, we not only recommend that these rooms are well insulated to accommodate for the heat absorbed below. In cases such as these, we highly recommend hydroband board being placed below your strata heat system, which will dramatically increase the efficiency of your system, as explained in the installation instructions for the product. As you may or may not know, strata heat can be installed under tile, stone, laminate, carpet, wood floors, you name it. But what a lot of people don't consider is that the type of finished flooring actually is going to have a large factor on if these strata heat systems can be relied on as a primary heat source in a space. For example, tile and stone are going to be the most efficient typically when installing over a strata heat system. Just the nature of the product is going to allow you to run at a maximum temperature if desired. Or if you get into laminates and vinyl floors, for example, you have to check with the finished flooring manufacturer to see the max temp that can be used with those types of products. And then wood and carpet are typically least efficient finished flooring over radiant heat systems and would not be optimal choices in poorly insulated rooms. Based solely on the fact that these types of floorings are dense, the wood and the carpet is not going to allow for that heat to transfer through the material and up into the room easily. So long story short, as you can see here, using strata heat as a primary heat source can be done, but there's certainly some factors that you have to consider before doing so. Just a little bit of research and preparation on the front end is going to go a long way to make sure that that space is performing as you intended when the project is complete. And in hand, you're not upset that the floor isn't heating the whole room when in fact it's not the floor's fault, it's the engineering and just the nature of the space that it's being installed in. Hope this information was helpful. Take care.